to be on. Golda? Golda? Are you home? Golda? Where are you, Golda? I've come because I have such news for you. Golda? Golda? Have you seen Golda? No? Well, if you see her, tell her Yente the matchmaker was here, and I have a perfect match for her daughter Zaitel. Well, I must be off. So goodbye, and it was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other. Just a moment, please. I feel like I have forgotten something. Have I? Of course I have. Oh, I'm losing my head. Someday it will fall off altogether, and a horse will kick it into the mud, and goodbye, Yenta. Of course, the news. It's about these weird new inventions called feet. If you're not on them right now, you should be. No, no, that's not right, is it? Of course it's not. What's that thing called? A chair! You see those things around the tables? Yes, they're perfect for you. You could not do better for your bum. True? True. Hey, you, over there in the fancy dress, sit your tush down. You too, sir. Yes, yes, I'm talking to you, ma'am. Sit down, very good. I'm waiting. Sit, sit. Very good. Now, when should we make the party? I'm free right now, so sit. Congratulations. May you always be happy and healthy, yes? Yes. Now, I have a surprise for you. Here they are, come. Wonderful children, from good families. Each of them a prize, a jewel. You could not do better for your entertainment. Just right, from the top of the tree. I give you the Fiddler on the Roof cast.
My friends are back. Please welcome Rabbi Chaitovsky and Rabbi Gelman.
We're going to make hamotzi, and I'm going to wash my hands on behalf of everyone here. Just while I make the hamotzi, think about the following idea. As the Jews were traveling throughout the desert for 40 years, manna came from heaven, provided for their every nutritional need, maybe not every nutritional want, but every nutritional need. Then they get to Israel, the manna stops, they plant the seed in the ground, and wheat, fruits, vegetables come out of the ground. They had not seen that before. And imagine how excited they were when someone for the first time made the blessing, "Blessed are you, O Lord, ruler of the world, who brings bread," or the raw material for bread, "out of the earth." This is a very exciting evening, pleasure for me to be able to participate right here at our honorees' table. And without any further ado, washing and hamotzi. Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al netzilat yadayim. Blessed are you, ruler of the world, Lord our God, who has sanctified us with mitzvot and asked us to wash our hands before eating certain foods, including bread. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the world, who brings forth bread from the earth.
My dear friends, this is a complicated time to be celebrating. To be celebrating wonderful honorees and a wonderful school. It's going to be a complicated time to celebrate Purim on Motzei Shabbat on Saturday night, considering all that the Jewish people are going through, the war in Gaza. So it's appropriate for us to take a moment to focus on that, to focus on our beloved Medinat Yisrael, State of Israel, and of course to focus on the hostages and their families. So I'm going to kindly ask everyone to just rise in their places so we can focus on these tefillot. First, a prayer for the state of Israel, and then a prayer on behalf of the hostages. Avinu shebashamayim, tzur Yisrael v'goalo, barech et medinat Yisrael reishit tzmichat geulatenu, hagen aleha bevrat chastecha ufros aleha sukat shlomecha, ushlach orcha v'yamitcha l'rasheha sareha v'yoatzeha, v'taknein be'etza tova milfanecha chazek, et yidei migine eretz kachenu, v'anchilem Eloheinu Yeshua v'yater netzachon tatreim, v'natata shalom ba'aretz, v'simchat olam liyoshveha. Rock and Redeemer of Israel, bless the state of Israel, the start of the flowering of our redemption. Shield it with your love, spread over it the shelter of your peace, guide its leaders and advisors with your light and your truth, establish for them your good counsel, strengthen the hands of the defenders of the Holy Land, cause them to inherit our God deliverance, place the crown of victory upon them, give the land peace and everlasting joy to its inhabitants, and let us say Amen. Mishaberech Avoteinu Avraham Yitzhak V'Yaakov Moshe Aharon David Ushlamo Yivarech V'Yishmor V'Yinsur Et Nedrei Tzvagana L'Yisrael V'Et HaShivuyim B'toch Shara Achenu Beit Yisrael HaNetunim B'Tzara U'V'Shivya. May the one who blessed Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, Moses, Aaron, David, and Solomon bless, watch, and guard those missing in action from the Israeli Defense Forces and the captives among our brethren of the House of Israel that are in distress and captivity. On account of this congregation's praying for them, may the Holy One, blessed be He, grant mercy upon them, take them from darkness and gloom, break their chains, redeem them from their ordeals, and return them quickly to the comfort of their families. Let them praise the Lord for His kindness and His wondrous deeds for the children of man. And through them, let the verse be fulfilled. Ufiduye Adonai Yeshuvun, Uvaot Zion Birina V'Simchat Olam Arosham, Sason V'Simcha Yasigu V'Nasu Yagon V'Anacha. And the Lord's ransom shall return and come with shouting to Zion, crowned with joy. Everlasting they shall attain joy and gladness, while sorrow and sighing flee. And let us say, Amen.
Please welcome our event co-chairs, Haiti and Brian Demain, and Sarah and Brad Nieder.
People try to put us to death.
Talking about my generation.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Thank you, Rabbi Chaitovsky and Rabbi Gelman, and thank you all for being here, 600 strong friends, supporters of Denver Jewish Day School. Thank you so much. My name is Brad Nieder. I'm one of the co-chairs tonight, along with my lovely and talented and sweet and smart and beautiful wife, Sarah. Yeah, you can applaud. She's a fan favorite, I know. Yes, the only reason I get out of the house, that's right. And our other co-chairs here, the lovely and talented and sweet and smart dear friend of ours, Dr. Haiti Demain. And let's not forget Haiti's very handsome husband, movie star Richard Gere.
Tonight we celebrate DJDS Le Dor Va Dor from generation to generation, and we honor Krista Boscoe, whose 25 years of service to the school have spanned two generations. Krista has led us in three capital campaigns to build our Upper Division campus in 2002, our Jewish Future campaign several years ago, and then our Raise Your Hand campaign, where I had the privilege to work closely with Krista on our teacher salary endowment and our 50s wing remodel. Krista also created our High Five Club Giving Society, launched and grew our Legacy Society, and kept the school financially strong over many tumultuous years.
If you ran into Krista in the past year, she undoubtedly gave you a save the date card. And if you ran into her multiple times, you likely received multiple save the date cards, each one getting increasingly more aggressive.
Well, we know those are some Tony Soprano tactics, but they've clearly worked. Who are we to critique Krista's methods when she has raised $58.5 million and counting? Thank you, Krista.
That's true. We looked it up. We did look it up. That's an accurate figure, yes. Thank you to art teacher Mr. Chartier and the many DJDS students who created the centerpieces for you tonight. We know many of you are enjoying the nostalgic look back at those photos. Haiti and Sarah are actually alumni of the school, and they had a great time digging up some old memories from their old yearbook. Take a look at this.
Here you can see us in the yearbook from 1991 when we were in seventh grade. We call that triangle hair. And here is my actual inscription to Sarah in her yearbook. It's hard to read my writing, so I'll give you the summary. Sarah, you've been a really cool person. Your food is great, especially your bugles. And I hope you get a fine guy soon.
Well, Hades' wish for me came true 20 years ago.
I hope so.
Right here in this ballroom. Here's a photo of our wedding, right here at the Sewell Ballroom.
The ceiling, you can tell the ceiling.
Yep. And of course, you all remember Hadie and Richard's wedding.
Very cinematic.
Well, first comes love, and then comes marriage, and then comes the next generation, all of whom have been classmates together at DJDS. We have Holden and Isaac, Mara and Molly, and Stanley and Sylvie. And just to show that history repeats itself, here's an inscription from Stanley to Sylvie in last year's yearbook. Dear Sylvie, stay cool. Can I come to your house this year, this summer, to eat more red vines? Lador Vador indeed.
We seek to keep DJDS strong for the next generation and beyond, so we are innovating for the future thanks to all of your support. In particular, we thank our partners, all of whom you can see on the screen. Thank you to Amity and Mark Cooper, Debbie and Michael Feiner, Lisa Reckler-Cohn and Rich Cohn, Lauren and Daniel Schulman, Betty Cooper, the Metzel, Fiddler, and Max families, and Deborah and Scott Michaud. That'll be up there in a moment, I know it will. The Coopers, Cones, and Schulmans, and the Metzel, Fiddler, and Max families, there it is it up there? Yes, have been contributing to our dinner or matching dollars for many, many years, and we are grateful for their ongoing support. Please give a hand to all of our partners.
Thank you also to our table captains. Without you, we would not have set a record for the largest attendance ever at a DJDS annual dinner. And a big thanks to Sam, Melissa, Pam, Matan, Allison, Avi, all of our volunteers, and even Krista, who helped plan her own dinner. They are all real pros and have made our jobs as chairs so easy. And how about a hand for Chagit and our DJDS theater students who entertained us this evening. And let's not forget our two great principals, Alana Shapiro of the lower division and Jeremy Golubko-Teglasi, lovingly known as Dr. GT, of the upper division.
Okay, here's what's going to happen next. We will hear from our illustrious head of school, Avi Halzel. We will hear from our one and only outstanding honoree, Krista Boscoe. We will hear remarks from our very engaging DJDS alumnus, Simon Kaufman, class of 2012. You will definitely want to pay attention to what Simon has to say. And then our distinguished DJDS board chair, Rich Cohn, will close the program.
And after Rich speaks, we're going to have dinner served within seconds. So please stay put when Rich is done. Do not get up. Don't get in the way of the servers. We've innovated this year. There is no salad plate.
Yes.
There is just this hummus bowl, and it is a real game changer. So there's nothing to clear. Your dinner plate will be served quickly as long as you follow the rules. Good luck with this crowd. Then after that, you can eat and schmooze to your heart's content. The bar will remain open. Dessert and coffee will be available in the back of the room. Don't forget to bid in the silent auction. Just scan the code in your program booklet. And don't forget the alumni after party, location given only to the cool people, so ask around. And we will be serving these red vines at the after party.
Yeah.
No bugles, as they are no longer certified kosher. Fun fact.
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody. Take it away, Avi.
Please welcome Avi Halzel.
Should have gone slower. I love that song. Tonight, we celebrate legacies of the past and embrace innovations of the present and future, marking a moment of pride and forward motion for Denver Jewish Day School. Let's start by reflecting on how we got where we are today. When I arrived at Denver Jewish Day School, Krista Boscoe was already a legend. Honestly, it was a little intimidating. She didn't hold back, letting you know what she thought. You know Krista. As we got to know each other, I learned to appreciate her assertiveness and understand how it was directly related to her success as a fundraiser, and what great success she has had. Tonight, we honor Krista, whose tireless efforts help shape the very fabric of our school. It is with heartfelt gratitude that we soon bid her farewell into her retirement. Krista, we extend our deepest thanks to you for your dedicated service and profound impact on our school. As we reflect on Krista's remarkable contributions, we turn our attention to the broader success of Denver JDS. There are many indicators of our success, and perhaps the most important one resides in our alumni. So, on a night when we are honoring our past, let's highlight a few of our alumni. Zoe Bernstein, class of 2010, told us that she graduated with a service-oriented mindset because DJDS always stressed tikkun olam and volunteering. Zoe also explained that one of the things that was really helpful in college and then law school were the writing skills she learned from Mr. Kogan, her high school English teacher. Yeah. Zoe became a fast an organized reader and writer, which helps her as a very successful prosecutor today. David Kornfeld, class of 2016, he attended the California Institute of Technology and then began working at SpaceX on the power electronics team. David is in charge of the motor systems for Starship, SpaceX's new massive rocket platform, which NASA is using to bring people to the moon in 2026 and eventually to Mars. When he was here at Denver JDS, who would have thought that the skills that David was learning would eventually help him enable Starship's interplanetary travel? Wow. Many of you know Rabbi Emily Hyatt. Did you know that Rabbi Hyatt is a K-12 graduate of DJDS from the class of 2003? Yes. Rabbi Hyatt of Temple Emmanuel is a valued member of our community as she inspires us with her eloquent teaching and wisdom. Rabbi Hyatt is on the DJDS Board of Trustees and continues the generational connection as the parent of an awesome DJDS student. Avi K, class of 2018. After graduating from DJDS, Avi attended Stanford University, just like his three older brothers following their respective matriculation from DJDS. Avi is now in medical school and already giving excellent medical advice, as he did with me when he informed me that my kidney stone, based on its size, would not pass on its own. Sadly, he was correct. There you have it, a doctor, a lawyer, a rabbi, and an engineer. And that's just a few of our amazing alumni. As family and community members, much of what we want for our kids is for them to be happy, healthy, productive, and good members of society. put aside the amazing career paths that our alumni have. They are amazing individuals who care about the impact they have, care about their families and friends, and they bring their strong Jewish identity forward while doing great things in the world. Lots to be proud of there. And as we look to the future, we know that many of the jobs of the future do not even exist today, at least not in their current form. That's why we continually challenge what we do and how we do it, all to make sure that our graduates are fully prepared for their next stage. In fact, DJDS leadership is now in the process of rethinking what classes look like and what our learning spaces look and feel like. That also includes a topic discussed here from this stage, our continued efforts to bolster how we compensate our incredible teachers. In fact, please join me in giving the DJDS faculty a rousing round of applause. They are the best. An example of our continued evolution and innovation can be seen with the Lower Division Helping Hands program. This is a powerful service learning project that has been part of our school for some time, and yet we felt that we could make it even better. This year, we are innovating and expanding the Helping Hands program by integrating the outstanding Tikkun curriculum into the program. Under the direction of Principal Alana Shapiro, our teachers are working with the Tikkun curriculum creator to more fully integrate service learning into grade-level curricular units of study. This provides our students with deeper hands-on learning in science, social studies, and Judaic studies lessons. It is through continuing to innovate in programs like this that we instill critical thinking skills that our students will need in their future paths. In the upper division, under first-year principal Dr. GT, the schedule was restructured on Wednesdays to make time for a full day of community building, academic enrichment, and extracurricular activities. Now, Wednesdays begin with an assembly to set the tone. The assembly includes tefillah, games, and guest speakers. Assembly is followed by grade-level advisory meetings and then a full day of a wide variety of electives, including foreign language classes, robotics, Jewish tech study, and much, much more. The ability of our students to drive their own learning experiences shaped by topics of greatest interest to them has been a huge success in engaging students in their own learning. At DJDS, we regularly face different types of challenges. COVID comes to mind. Over the last 6 months, a different type of innovation was necessary. Following the October 7th Hamas attack, we once again sprung into our Jewish values. Since the start of the war, we have been helping Israelis and supporting IDF soldiers. We are especially proud of the way our community welcomed 16 visiting Israeli students and their families into our school. Yeah. That is the power of Jewish values. That is the power of our community, and that is the power of Denver JDS. Meanwhile, over 100 hostages are still held in captivity in Gaza. We pray for their release and that the war ends soon. Am Yisrael Chai. When thinking about innovation, we are turning big dreams into reality. From the teacher salary endowments to the newly opened pre-K, our strategic initiatives are coming to life now. We recently announced that DJDS is moving forward with a comprehensive renovation of the kindergarten through third grade wing. It will undergo a complete remake this summer and will be ready for the start of the upcoming school year. Good applause for that. It's been a long time coming. Our makerspace will also undergo a relocation and renovation with the creation of a new, modern innovation space in the specials wing. These innovation spaces will be used by DJDS students across all grades. Every aspect of these spaces has been thoroughly reimagined to support the evolving needs of our students. These transformative projects will modernize our facilities and enrich the learning environment for our students, paving the way for an even brighter future That's how we continue to graduate and will continue to graduate world-class students who are world-class people. Note, please, that the fundraising for these renovation projects is ongoing. Your involvement makes our shared vision possible. We extend our immense thanks to you, our family, our friends, our guests. You are our Denver Jewish Day School community. Together, we are shaping an innovative future of Jewish education and empowering students to thrive in an ever-changing world. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for your support. Toda rabah.
We were just coming together as Herzl and Ramat, and Krista just rose to the occasion, got it together, and the incredible relationships that she made with everybody. So from answering yes 25 years ago for the campus, she's also answered yes in so many other areas.
In that first year when we were thinking about building the campus, we had these plans for what buildings we wanted to build. And I said, Krista, is that even possible? And I just remember, she just looked me straight in the eye and said, Phil, we are going to do this.
My memories of school are with my mother, and that was always really meaningful to me, to know that she was there behind the scenes.
When I think back on phases from becoming a black belt in karate to, you know, being a lawyer and going to law school to being heading in fundraising, and her involvement here at the school, it's always just amazing to me where she gets the energy from.
Finding Judaism later on in her life and to be such a strong advocate for a Jewish identity and a Jewish education has really been something special to see as her son.
She has a passion for causes that she believes in, helping to start the HIP program in Israel, and we've had Israelis stay at our house many, many times over the years.
The campaign that we led with the Seidels when I was board chair, it was critical for the school. And Krista was laser focused on our mission, and she was fearless. And so her confidence taught me that even in difficult circumstances, you just keep after it.
When I first met Krista, she invited my whole family to her house for Shabbat dinner to get to know the kind of warm and kind and caring and deeply Jewish person that Krista is.
She has really been so important to the success of this school. It's more than just a job, it's really been a life passion.
Mazel tov, Mom, on an amazing career. You have always been a role model of mine, and to see you come to a close at your amazing career is truly special.
And the fact that you have dedicated yourself to the legacy of our Judaism and our culture, and I'm so proud of what you've accomplished and want to wish you mazel tov.
Mazel tov, Krista, on this well, well-deserved honor. I love you, and thank you.
Mazel tov, Mom!
Please welcome Krista Boscoe.
Amazing. I've probably spoken to many of you personally over the last several years, but seeing 600 of you here now, that's just amazing. I can't believe this is our largest dinner yet. I'm not going to say ever, I'm going to say yet. And I'm grateful and honored that all of you showed up, came. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Much appreciated. Co-chairs, this room looks amazing. Thank you for using my favorite color, purple. I wonder how you knew. And I don't know who to really thank for some of those pictures on the table, but I'm pretty sure I know who. Hopefully we can break both our attendance and fundraising numbers tonight, even factoring in Lisa Reckler Cohn's inflation calculation from when she and Mark Seidel were honored in 2018. I hope we can still beat it. <laughs> 28 years ago, this time, I was giving birth to our youngest son, Sam. Happy birthday, Sam. Go ahead and have a drink on me. Got it. 3 years later, that same month, I joined the staff of Herzl, which soon became Denver Jewish Day School. I want to thank Dottie Resnick, Ruth Malman, and Saul Lefton for having the vision to hire me for what I thought was going to be a couple-year job. 25 years later, a job of fundraising in the Jewish community, no less, has turned into an amazing career. In that 25 years, I learned that the average development person stays in their position for 2.5 years. I also kept in mind Eleanor Roosevelt's quote, "When you think you have reached the end of your rope, tie a knot and hold on." Mostly I wondered, what's wrong with me? But I love this job. Part of the reason I've been successful is because of my husband, Mark. Thank you. Mark also shares a passion for the Jewish community and has supported my career path. Having kids that attended the school gave me an inside view into the and a deep appreciation for the teachers. Thank you, teachers. But the time has come to turn the reins over to my successor, Samantha Raisin Walsh. Sam is more than ready to keep the school's development department going strong well into the future. And after all, she's had the best training over the last several years. I would like to acknowledge two wonderful board chairs I served under while I was on the Herzl board, and then 12 amazing board chairs for the combined campus I served under and learned so much from. Did the school have hard times? Yes, but it was successfully led by Phil Kalin and Avi Halzel as heads of school. Thank you, Janie, Ruth, Cece, Dottie, Cheryl, Peter, Howard, David B., David F., Lisa Reckler Cohn, Leslie, Arit, and Rich. And your board members kept me well connected to this job. An area of my job that I have so enjoyed talking to many of you about is your legacy for the Jewish community. I believe what goes around comes around. And the top 1% of all nonprofits know that the road to success is paved with planned gifts. It's no coincidence that the best of the best have strong legacy giving programs, and DJDS is one of the best. For those of you who have already included Denver Jewish Day School in your legacy plans, I thank you. Please know that your gifts will keep the school going strong for many years to come, and you will be rewarded many times over for being visionary leaders. Rose Community Foundation started the endowment challenge in the late 1990s, and the school participated to start our endowment. Since then, Rose has put in place Live On to encourage our Jewish nonprofits to grow our endowments. Thank you, Rose, for allowing Denver Jewish Day School to be a part of your work. It is never too late to add Denver Jewish Day School to your estate plans. I'll be working until this summer, so get a hold of me, and I'm happy to help make that happen for you. What else have I loved about my job? All of you amazing donors who believe in the mission of Denver Jewish Day School, as well as the outstanding teachers, students, alumni, alumni parents, and community supporters. Looking back over the years, it has been the remarkable friendships I've formed and the connections I've made. It has been a wonderful ride. Now, I look forward to seeing many of you on the bike trails and the golf courses. Thank you for allowing me to enjoy the ride.
What happens when there's a community and people really know each other, there's more of like a human element, which was not something I grew up going to huge public schools. You know, there was no individualized learning. Whereas here, I think there actually is like, oh, you're interested in this. Like, let me talk to you after class.
Having the opportunity to get to know your teachers and all your friends on a really personal level, so it makes this school like unique.
Coming here in seventh grade, I was a shy 13-year-old kid, just moved from a huge public school to a tiny Jewish day school with 30 kids in my class, and then two, becoming the school's student council president, I think it was a huge jump for me. And with credit to teachers, I think they played a key piece in my growth here.
It almost seems like your education is designed specifically for you because teachers are willing to take different routes for different students.
There's a beautiful magic when you watch your kids be independent in their own way. That's the school is still continuing to offer enough choices that it allows each kid to shine.
To see his involvement in non-sports related activities, to see him come home and be excited about chess and art and different blast classes that are offered, it's been really fun.
To feel completely comfortable with where he is, who he is around, what he is learning, there's like really no words to describe it.
They have the opportunity to really try things and get the support to try them that I just don't think happens in a lot of their places because it just doesn't feel supportive.
We're trying to bring into our school program those experiences that we know lift people's spirits and souls and minds. And so we took this leap, starting with doing moot court.
Every time I sit down with Dr. GT to go over my argument, I feel like I learned something totally new. Leading up to the state tournament. In our second year to have two national qualifiers already, it's amazing to see how much we've been able to do.
I never even thought it'd be possible to be a founding member and captain for Moot Court or for Model UN, or to be a part of the basketball team. And coming to this school, I didn't even think of the amazing friendships I would have. I have been able to be a part of a family across so many grades and communities. Not something that we just care about, it's something that we are.
Everyone is here to see me grow. Because of that, I think I am prepared for real life.
Please welcome Simon Kaufman.
Krista, I'm going to put this right here. For the Rockies fans, that was Larry Walker's walk-up song. And I always dreamed that it would be mine when I made the majors. But having it as my walk-up song for my Jewish day school's annual dinner is far, far better. Good evening. I am Simon Kaufman, class of 2012, and I am beyond honored to be here tonight. There is a common refrain at this school that at Denver Jewish Day School, we are family. When I was here, we even started breaking our sports team huddles with mishpacha, family in Hebrew, a term that not only reminded us that our teammates had our back, but also one that always confused our opponents. In my case, this school is family and continues to be. I actually remember at one point during my DJDS career, I had a cousin in every grade K through 12. And just when I thought that I was done with this school, I learned that it would continue to be a part of my family. My younger sister married another DJDS alum, Sam Boscoe. You see, I played on a lot of high school sports teams with Sam and often drove him home after our practices. He'd always ask about my family and how we were doing. Little did I know at the time he was angling to eventually join our family. But the real reason I want to mention Sam is because while you think we might be here to celebrate Krista, that's only a ruse to celebrate another Bosco. As we learned, today is actually Sam's birthday. And as I've learned, part of my role as a new brother-in-law is that I don't only get to embarrass my younger sister, but now also my younger brother. So on the count of three, all 600 of us are going to sing happy birthday to Sam. And I can't do this alone, so I need your help. One, two, three. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. You all thought you would just come here, eat dinner, and wouldn't have to sing. I told them letting me speak would be a huge risk. Which brings us to perhaps what many of you are now asking yourselves, what is this guy doing here? Sure, if you listened closely to my singing of happy birthday, you noticed I did hit those high key notes. But keynote speaker? What did I do to deserve to be on this stage tonight? Yes, I captained the junior varsity basketball team as a senior. Thank you. Some of you might even recall the 7 total points I scored during my high school career. Please. Others of you may recognize me as the 3-time winner of the IJN's Hanukkah coloring contest between the ages of 7 and 11. Those accolades, while certainly prestigious, are not the reason that I believe I ended up on this stage. I believe I'm here tonight because of a mistake I made during my 2012 graduation speech. The date is May 23rd, 2027. My accountant called to let me know that I had just made my first $1 billion. Yes, billion. So I kick back at my desk for a moment and look outside my office window overlooking the majestic city skyline. I reflect on this heady milestone, but I am interrupted when my iPhone 37S rings. Hello, this is Simon. On the other end, I hear a familiar voice. Hi, Simon. This is Krista Boscoe. I went on to explain that night, almost 12 years ago, that I quickly realized my financial success wouldn't have been possible without my Denver Jewish Day School Foundation, and I ended my remarks by telling Krista I would commit the full $1 billion to the school. I regret to inform you, the reality is that I haven't exactly followed that trajectory. But one thing that was true then and is true now is that when Krista calls, I answer. Krista has been calling this community for more than 25 years, and in doing so, has been answering a call, one that deeply believes in the value of a Jewish education and a commitment to community. When Krista calls, this community has answered time and time again to make institutions like DJDS possible, and for that, this community and I am forever indebted. Krista, there is no one more deserving of being recognized. Another huge mazel tov on a tremendous career. So I didn't become a billionaire. So what did I do in the 12 years since I donned that funny looking robe and hat on my graduation stage? I regret to inform you, I did not become a doctor, lawyer, rabbi, nor engineer. I have gotten to do what I told people I was going to do since I was in fifth grade, work in broadcast journalism. In middle school, I would wake up early so I had just enough time to catch the last 7 minutes of the local news, including the sports report, and then the first 10 minutes of the Today Show before I headed off for school. I dreamed of working in TV. We didn't have a school television program or a journalism program. Instead, a few teachers, including Jerry Rotenberg, Mr. Doze, and Mr. Snyder, encouraged me to start a student newspaper. So with their help and the help of many friends and classmates, I did. My senior year, I was actually lucky enough to serve as student council president in addition to being editor of the paper. This was a great lesson in the need for an objective press. Needless to say, the paper was very, very kind to my student council administration, and my polling consistently topped 95%. But the highlight of my high school journalism career was when Josh Lake told me that he had secured a Chassa High School sports press credential for me. That meant I could go to any high school game and cover it. I may not have ever made the varsity basketball team, but I spent my final 2 years of high school chronicling the boys and girls varsity teams, often scoring exclusive interviews with star players, my friends who did make the team. A few years later, as an editor of my college's student newspaper, I sat courtside next to writers from ESPN and Sports Illustrated, chronicling the University of Michigan's pursuit of a national championship. Go Blue. The gym was a little bigger, and the teams unfortunately didn't break their huddles with mishpacha, but one thing was the same. When I published my story after the game, one of my DJDS English teachers was the first to reach out. He said congrats, and he let me know that I used a semicolon when I probably could have gotten away with just a colon. Michigan lost that game, and in hindsight, I probably would have been better sticking around to cover the Tigers had I wanted to witness a championship in person. After graduating, I went on to pursue a career in sports journalism, this time behind the scenes in television, because as an old DJDS friend likes to remind me, despite my sports acumen, I still have a face for radio. I worked the 2016 Olympics for NBC, then moved to Chicago to work as a producer for a national sports network. After 4 years of covering some of the biggest sports events, I pivoted to news and was lucky enough to start a role as a producer on a national morning show, one not too different from the one I used to wake up early to watch every morning in elementary school. While I consider myself tremendously lucky to get to work in an industry I dreamed of as a fifth grader, I have found that among my DJDS peers, my story is not unique. One of my classmates spent a lot of his time in class doodling, sketching city skylines and urban landscapes. During Color War, a teacher encouraged that friend to get involved in crafting the team banner. He developed a knack for building and creating. That friend is now a leading architect in Seattle. I have a friend who loved to plan events. She even organized the first DJDS school dance. Now she does that on a bigger scale, working as a premier wedding planner in Los Angeles, coordinating the details for some of Hollywood's biggest affairs. I have friends and a brother whose greatest passion was hijinks and making their friends laugh. Events like Color War let them put those talents on display. They turned a Color War lip sync act into a viral America's Got Talent act and now a licensed Las Vegas show. I had a friend who we nicknamed Game Face because of his competitive drive and passion for making people better. I am thrilled, but not at all surprised, that he is still doing that as the head coach of the boys' basketball team here. I should note that Matan's high school career included many more points than my 7. And I had one friend who, during our 10th grade trip to Israel, immediately fell in love with the country. She told us that she was going to come back someday. She took a gap year after we graduated and lived there, and has never left. I am beyond proud to say that she is one of more than 20 DJDS alums who served recently in the Israel Defense Forces, and I am confident and optimistic about Israel's future, knowing that some of my former classmates who learned the importance of Zionism in classrooms alongside me are protecting our homeland. All of these friends' journeys, like mine, started at Denver Jewish Day School. What happens in the hallways on Wabash Street sparks a belief that your dreams, be them in academics or entertainment, in science or sports, can become careers. But what makes this place special is that at DJDS, we weren't encouraged to simply pursue careers that we were passionate about. We were pushed to seek out lives that bring us joy, to build communities and make the ones we're living in better. It's why in Chicago, I serve on my Jewish Federation's Young Adults Board, and why my fiance and I host Shabbos dinners each week with friends. It's why my friend who started a business here in Denver pivoted all of his operations during COVID to bring meals to frontline workers. And it's why in other times of need, it's often the members of this community that are the very first to step up and answer the call. This school doesn't want its graduates to become billionaires. It wants them to become innovators, inventors, creators, leaders, advocates, activists, and philanthropists who are inspired by their Jewish values, people who will make a billion different types of difference in this world. With that said, had I become a billionaire, I assure you the school would have had no problem accepting a portion of that. And I promise you that money would all be coming back to the school as a long overdue thank you, and to ensure that this school can continue to carry out its mission. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is called a segue. Tonight, I'm giving Krista the night off. Tonight, I'm calling on you to make a difference. Nights like tonight aren't just incredible opportunities to bring our community together. They're ones in which we show we're committed to the future of this community and the future of building that community for every Jewish kid who wants to be a part of it. Here, every Jewish child, regardless of their financial means, has a place. To make this happen, DJDS provides $3 million of tuition assistance to nearly two-thirds of our students each year. So here's what we're going to do. Tonight, you and I are going to invest in this community asset. The money we raise will be earmarked to provide needs-based scholarships, to provide security to keep DJDS students safe, to provide books and laptops to help them learn, and to provide funds to help pay our incredible teachers and faculty. In short, the money we raise tonight will help our students feel the warm embrace of this school, help them receive the outstanding education that DJDS provides, and help them become community leaders. To give you an additional incentive, every dollar you contribute tonight will be tripled thanks to our generous match donors whose names are listed on the screen. A huge thank you to all of them. And if you need just a little more incentive, gifts above $2,500 are eligible for the Colorado Child Care Tax Credit. You can learn more about that credit and how it may impact you through the chart on your table, but just as a quick example, a $25,000 donation for many people could result in less than $8,000 out of pocket. A $10,000 donation for many people could result in just $3,000 out of pocket. I have been told by the lawyers that I have to let you know that you should consult your tax advisor on this. If you don't have a financial advisor, look to your left, look to your right. I am certain you will find one. Table captains, if you haven't already, please pass out the pledge cards placed on your tables. You can fill out a pledge card and hand it to a staff member or a DJDS senior who will be circulating. There is also a QR code on the pledge card that will be up on the website online. Either way, whether you fill out the pledge card tonight or donate online through the website, your gift will be tripled tonight. Finally, you can designate a day of giving page to give to. Many of our table captains and others have committed to raising funds for this event, including our upper division students. For example, you could give a gift to honor the incredible 25-year career that Krista has had. Others of you might be interested to give a gift in honor of my 7 career high school basketball points on junior varsity. Really hard to say which is more deserving of your support. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Thank you for choosing to support this incredible school that means so much to me and all of you. And thank you all for your generosity.
Please welcome Rich Cohn.
Can't stop addicted to the shindig. Chop top, it says I'm gonna win big. Well, good evening. We're in the home stretch here. Dinner is just about ready to serve. I am Rich Cohn, chair, not so much distinguished, but chair nonetheless of the Denver JDS Board of Trustees, and I am so pleased to see everybody here tonight celebrating with us. Thank you all for being here. Krista, congratulations again on this very, very well-deserved honor. Your 25-year commitment and dedication to DJDS has helped make our school the special and remarkable place it is. And while there have been moments when I have said, you want me to call how many more people, or you want me to meet with who? Working with you has been a highlight of my term as board chair, so I am grateful, thank you. Simon, thank you for your inspiring remarks and showing us the impact that Denver Jewish Day School has on its students. You are the perfect example of what DJDS teaches our kids to become. Thank you again to all of our sponsors. Once again, hopefully displayed on the screen. And lastly, I want to thank all of you, not just for being here, but because everybody here in this room is committed to ensuring that our school and our students thrive. As we have seen tonight, Denver Jewish Day School is an extraordinary institution, impacting our students and our broader Denver Jewish community in powerful ways. In addition to providing students with an outstanding academic education, Denver JDS empowers our kids to grow to be confident, well-adjusted, purposeful people. And through Jewish values, Denver JDS teaches our kids to be curious, to ask questions, to be aware of what's happening in the world around us and in our community, to be engaged, and to act. And your support makes all of this possible. So thank you. I know that everyone is waiting anxiously for dinner to be served. We mentioned earlier tonight
that dinner will be served quickly. There's no moving of any salad plates. So please, as mentioned earlier again, stay seated as the wait staff comes out momentarily. While you wait, don't forget about our Tigers for Tzedakah Day of Giving campaign and our silent auction, information both of which are contained in your dinner packets. The auction, the silent auction, has been extended and will end tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock, so please bid and bid high. And thank you again for being here this evening and for your support of the school. B'tei Havon.